the previous video we have discussed about how to use this Scanner class, and I have given a homework of the program you have seen in front of your screen, that is write a program to accept number from user and display addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So I hopefully you have done the program, and here is a solution. So I have written, I have used Java class that is Scanner to accept the numbers. So I have used the Scanner class, as I have described how to use the Scanner class, and I have taken two numbers, that is as integer int a equals ac dot next int, and in the second line int b equals to sc dot next int. So I have declared five variables, each of them doing the different tasks, like first one is addition, second is subtraction, third one is multiplication, this one is division with quotient, and last one is division modulus symbol, which gives out the answer of remainder of two numbers. So let us run this program. Right click void main, and we have to enter some number. Suppose I have give the first number as 5, then the third and second number as 3. So the addition of as expected. So 5 plus 3 is 8, 5 minus 3 is 2, 5 multiplied by 3 is 15, 3 ones are 3, so it is remainder is 1, and the remainder quotient is 1, and the remainder is 2. Now let us get in the types of variable. So there are three types of variable: local, instance and static. So what is local variable? A local variable are those variables which are declared inside a method. Like in this case, I have written a program class number, and inside that I have written public static void main. In that int a equal to 5, I have stored that number inside the variable a. Since the variable is declared inside a method, that is here main method, so the number which is getting stored inside the variable, this variable is a local variable. System.out.println, and we are printing the variable stored in value stored inside the variable as 5. So let us do this program. So let us write this program, new class. So let us write local demo. This is the demonstration of a local variable. And I write class local demo. Inside that I write public static void main, and followed by scanner is equal to new scanner system.in. Since scanner requires an import java.util, so import java.util.star, so that you can use the scanner class. Then I have to declare some variables. So I will write system.out.println enter a number. Then I have to write int a equal to sc dot next int to accept the number. Then I will, since this is a local variable, I will use a comment to make sure that you will understand properly. So local variable, and I will print that number system.out.println a. Now this is an explanation of a local variable. Let us compile this, close this part, and right click on that and click on void main. On clicking on void main, a terminal window has shown up which is asking for a number to input. So suppose I have given 10, so 10 has been thrown out. So this is an example of a local variable. Next is instance variable. So what is an instance variable? Instance variable are a variable which is declared outside a method but inside a class. So how to use this. So I have given a demonstration of an instance variable. So I've written class number, within that int a instance variable, public static void main. So the number which has the variable which has been declared in outside the public static void main, or any method you would like, there is anything inside the class but not inside the method, is an instance variable. So int a public static void main, so I've written inside that number n equals new number. So number is the class, n is the object, equals new is the initializer, and number is the constructor. Since instance variable can only be accessed with the help of a object of a class, so I have used n is the object. So n dot dot operator allows us to get inside a class to access its data members. So in this case, the data member is your instance variable. So n dot a equals to 5. So I've stored the value of 5 inside the variable a. Then I'm printing system.println n dot a, means that I'm using an object. Inside the object, I'm getting the variable a. So let us write a program to see and how to use this. So instance demo, we'll write import java dot util dot star class instance demo. So instance demo then followed by, you have to declare a variable int a, then you write public static void main. Inside that you have to make a object. So here the class name is instance demo. So instance demo, suppose I s equals to new instance demo. Then how to use that? I have just said is dot a equal to 5. A equal to 5, then we'll just print it out, system.out.println a, is.a. Then let us compile this and let's run this program. So you are seeing that 5 is being displayed. Now the final one is static variable. A static variable is a variable which can only be used in another static method. So what are the prerequisites of using a variable, static variable? Static variable must be explicitly declared as static. It cannot be declared inside a function or method. And in the future classes, as we will learn object-oriented programming, we will just get inside what are the uses of static variable. So let us see an example of how to use the static variable. So here you have written class number, within that I have written static int a. So you can just see over here that you have to write static keyword just before the variable name. So static just before the data type. So static int a public static void main, inside that I have written a equal to 5. So there's a key distinction between instance variable and static variable. The key instance distinction is that if you have just written a normal variable inside a class, and if you want to access that inside another method, you have to make a object of that. But in case of static, just look over here. Since public static, look over here. Here static is written inside. Static is written before the void main. Since you also remember that a static variable can only be accessed in another static method. So since class number static int a public static void main a equal to 5 system.out.println a, then bracket close. So let us see how to write this. So static demo. Inside that, I will write class static demo. Static demo, then you have to write within brackets public static void. So I write static int a equal to 5, then I write public static void main, and inside that I'll write system.out.println a. So how I am able to access this? Since a static method or a static class or a static variable can only be used inside another static method. That is why we can directly use the variable which has been declared outside the main method. So let's run this. Right click void main. So here you are seeing 5.